So here's another game tree. We have, again, two players, A and B, and A gets to make a choice first to go left or right, and B will find herself in a situation perhaps where she gets to choose to go left or right as well. I've drawn these little square boxes, though, to represent chance. So what this means is that if A goes left, you end up in a chance box where you flip a coin, and 50% of the time you end up over here, and 50% of the time you end up over here. Along a similar vein, if A goes right and then B goes left, then you end up at another chance node, and 80% of the time you end up here, and 20% of the time you end up here. Alternatively, if B goes right, you always end up here. Does that make sense?
I think so. Uh-huh.
So what we've done is we've gone from a two-player, zero-sum, deterministic game of perfect information to a two-player, zero-sum, non-deterministic game of perfect information. Okay? So we've relaxed. We've gone at least one level up in complexity. Okay, so do you understand this tree? Do you understand this setup?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, here the stochasticness is happening essentially at the leaves.
What does that mean?
That there's no choices to make for either player after this randomness happens. But is that, that's not what you mean in general, right?
No, that's right. There could be after here you end up in a different state where you can then make more choices. But okay, because I don't have enough room and because I want to make it simple, it just sort of ends after that.
Okay.
But yes, this tree could keep going on and there could be random choices, chance nodes happening everywhere. There could have been a chance node that happened at the very beginning even.
I feel like I could work out the value of this game.
Oh, well, how would you go about working out the value of the game?
I would probably have it as a quiz.
Okay. But what would the quiz look like?
It would say, what's the value of this game?
Okay. Do you think that just having that be the quiz is the best way for someone to learn? Or do you think maybe it can be done in stages?
Oh, I don't know. Do you have other questions that you want to ask?
Well, you know, how would you go about determining the value of the game? I think the first thing you would do, at least if you were patterning after what we just did, is you would try to write down a matrix.
Sure.
So I'm going to write down a matrix. So that our students will get a chance to work out what that matrix looks like, and then from there figure out the value of the game. Are you okay with that?
Sure.
Okay. So if we were going to do that, of course, the first thing we'd have to do is we'd have to figure out what the strategies are. So what are A's strategies?
I would have called them left and right, but they're not labeled.
Yeah, well, let's do that. Let's call them left and right. A can go left or A can go right. What about B's strategies?
B can go left or right.
And B can go left or right.